And welcome to our sixth grade graduation, class of 2014. We are so glad to have you here this evening. Good looking bunch too, don't you agree? Man, they clean up nice, especially after field day. So anyways, we're glad to have you this evening. My name is Mrs. Gould, and I'm the elementary principal here at Christian Life School. And I have truly had the pleasure of working with each one of your students throughout this year, some of them since kindergarten, others have just met this year. But what an honor it is to just see how they have grown into these wonderful young men and women, and I look forward to seeing all the amazing things that they're going to do here in the future as well. So I just wanted to extend my welcome to you today. At the same time, I'd also like to thank all of our parents who've helped out so much to make this such a special evening with the different decorations and the reception. So if you would just help me give those parents a round of applause, just who have been able to help us this year. And also at this time, I just want to take the opportunity to thank Mrs. Stewart, Mrs. Heilberg, and Mr. Kringle for all of the wonderful hours that they've poured into these students, the prayers that they have lifted up for them, the moments that they have just taken those extra moments to spend time with them and reach out to them. And so if you can help me thank their teachers as well. Well, we hope you enjoy your evening. And as we start out today, I'd just like to introduce to you Pastor Kevin Taylor, our co-lead pastor at Journey Church.
Good evening, everybody. We're glad you're here tonight. I just want to add a thank you to all of you, and just on behalf of Journey Church, for investing in Christian Life School and for believing in it. And man, this is a big class, isn't it? I'm hoping and trusting that you are sending them on to the upper school, where they will be in the great hands of another good team, such as grade school all the way through to senior high. And she's been thanking everybody else, but would you join me in a round of applause for Mrs. Gould, who also is doing amazing work here? Thank you. Let's pray. God, we're grateful to you for who you are and what you've done in our hearts and our lives. We're thankful for your life inside of us. Thank you for this whole group of students up here and for their accomplishments. God, I ask that you would continue to work in their life, and as they go forward in school and with you, God, that you would do great things through them, that you would pave the way for success the way that you see it, that you would help every parent here to just be the model of Jesus for them as they grow in faith and in education. And we ask that you would bless this night and all the festivities and celebrations that go with it. And we thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Well, this year's theme and verse was presented to by one of our students, Andrew Edwards, and I'm going to have him tell you about it.
This year's theme is strong enough, and its key verse is Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me.
Let's give him a round of applause. And he was chosen out of all the sixth grade classes just when they presented us something that was on their heart from this year, and something that they just felt demonstrated the theme of their whole class, and so that's why he was chosen. So well done. At this time, we're going to have Mrs. Foote lead our students in a song.
Well, I couldn't let this night go by without saying just a couple words, because this class was my very first class I started teaching music for here at CLS. And I don't know if they remember, they were also my first class, those of you who were here in kindergarten, who were my first ones to do kindergarten lunch duty. So, and I said, Lord, wow, what a great experience, and please don't make me do it again. So they were my first and my last. But I love them dearly, and I my prayer for you guys is that you will remember the verse that Andrew has for us and the song that we sang tonight. Not just the song, but what it means. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So what the song says, when all the world seems so hard and everything is coming at us, that nothing is too bad, that you can't do it with Christ. We aren't strong enough ourselves, but with Him, you can do all things. Just lean on Him. So I love you guys. I will miss you. So please come by and say hi next year.
Well, I'll just start while they're coming off. Sneak up here real quick. If it looks like I'm blushing, I'm not. I fried my face yesterday at the field trip. Which is a good thing, though, that our weather turned out really beautiful. And so I was real happy for that. Between that and Jimmy Santorelli working my arm out for the first time in a long time, throwing a baseball around for almost an hour, I woke up feeling like the Tin Man from The Wizard of Oz today. So it's been a long day. It's been a wonderful one, but I can't believe it's already here. I am Mr. Krangle, for those of you who don't know, and I am one of three sixth grade teachers that are just amazingly blessed to work with your kids. Got Mrs. Heilberg and Mrs. Stewart, who are an amazing team to work with. And just a quick shout out to Mrs. Nelson and Mrs. Gould for an amazing year of leadership once again. And the decorations committee, great job. Could we give it up one more time for these kids? They look amazing. Well, it's like I said, it's been a great year. They worked hard academically, and as a class, we have gone from what does the fox say to what does Jesus say, and everything in between. This group has made me laugh. This group has made me cry. I could tell you a whole bunch of stories, but we just don't have the time. But I do want to say one little thing. We do a lot of reading in my class. We go through the textbooks because I like the students to realize that they can make it through a science and a history curriculum, and at the end of the year, they're fine. They made it. They survived. So we do a lot of reading, but when you do a lot of reading, you have a lot of students that make a lot of mistakes, and it's very funny. Some of the things that they come up with and they say, and they're genuine and they're serious. It took me back to the days with my daughter April in third grade, and I remember just laying out on my bedroom floor, and April was, how would I put it? April was a little on the lazy side. So she had to learn those study habits. So I was headlocking her a lot of the times trying to get her to read. And I remember the first time we were reading about the Revolutionary War in third grade. And she was she started reading and she said, "The Midnight Ride of Paul Reiver." And I was just biting my tongue and she was all serious. And it's little things like that that you remember. And from this class in particular, there was a few of them that I just wanted to share. One of my students, when we were talking about the Quakers, this is just a quote right from the text. "Then in 1667, William Penn met a Quaker preacher and soon converted to the Quaker religion." As our man Sam. Anthony had just a beautiful one when we were talking about World War II and Joseph Stalin and the Soviet Union. And just, you know, straight through, and he was talking about Joseph Stallone. Stallone. It's absolutely hilarious. And probably the funniest one that I remember was, and of course it comes from a pastor's kid, our very own Sam Abbott. Twice in the same reading, we're talking about General MacArthur liberating the Philippines. And both times he was like, "General MacArthur liberated the Philippians." And I thought, hey, only from a pastor's kid, but that's a good thing. Spiritually, I've seen a lot of growth. However, parents, just one little word of warning. I have seen with this group that they can get their little heads turned very much by the world. And it's just because of the way the world is coming at them so fast nowadays with the internet and with all the social media that's going on. The enemy is just fighting for control of their little minds, and he wants to try to take them. And Romans 12:2 cautions us not to be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of our minds. So we got a lot of work ahead of time, a lot of work in the future to just keep on top of them. So make sure you're doing that. That being said, this is a very deeply sensitive group spiritually. Romans 10:13, "Whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved," was one of our key verses this year. We learned how to share our faith using the law and then bringing Jesus in once people understand their need for the Savior. And they learned how to do it. We did role modeling within the classroom. And so many of them already come to me that have been witnessing to people they know, family members, to other peers. And so that does my heart really proud. We had a powerful spiritual emphasis week chapel a little over a month ago with Pastor John from here at Journey Church. And it was amazing. He was talking to the kids about writing their story and leaving the foolish things behind and moving forward, because writing your story is such an important thing. And we need to move on with maturing and already getting to this age. Growing up, it's time to start heading that direction. So we're not doing a human video this year. I've been doing that a lot. But this year we have just a straight-up scripture performance for you, presentation, I should say, based on Andrew's verse. And then kind of in an eclectic style, we mixed in a few of the testimonies that the students had journaled about regarding that spiritual emphasis chapel. So without further ado, here we go.
Before I became a Christian, life was very tough at times. When I started to go to CLS, I was 4. Around that time, my Uncle Jim asked my dad and I to go to church with him. My dad said yes, and I think after about a month of going to church, my dad and I gave our lives to God. Ever since I gave my life to God, pretty much everything has been getting better. Now I praise the Lord for giving me talent and the abilities I have. I was baptized last summer, and it was awesome.
My relationship with Christ was weak around the middle of the year. Then I talked with Mr. C and he helped me, but it was still pretty weak. When Spiritual Emphasis Week took place this spring, Pastor John was cool, and each of the 3 days I got more in touch with God. The last day of chapel was the best to me because everybody in class came back to the room and talked about their relationship with God. This influenced me a lot.
I've always thought that God would get in the way of everything I wanted to be. It was like I was carrying a huge burden on my shoulders. I am in a Christian school and family, but like Pastor John said, if the devil can't make you hate God, he will make you bored. And that's exactly what he did to me. I was not happy at all. I wanted to love God, but I never felt connected. I will always remember Thursday, April 24th, 2014, the end of Spiritual Emphasis Week. That was the day Christ came into my heart and refreshed me. My friends and I all made the same connection with God that day, and because we have that in common, we are now some of the best friends in the world. It all happened because God gave me the courage to make that uncomfortable step, and I have never been better since.
I grew up in a very Christian family, so automatically you're going to think she's a strong Christian, but I wasn't. When you're little in Sunday school, you watch movies, play games, and make crafts. Then you hear some Bible stories over and over again, and it starts to get boring. When it gets boring, you sin more, because sinning seems like fun. But it's not. It just makes you sad, mad, depressed, and scared. You make jokes and get crazy and happy on the outside, so people think you're happy and have a great life, no problems at all. But newsflash, it's not true. Church is a boring snooze, right? Wrong. I've been learning that for the past 2 years. Church is amazing, and so are my Christian friends and family. I wouldn't be where I am today without them. Mr. Krangel has been a main part of it also. It is very easy to talk to him about this kind of stuff. I hope to walk further into my relationship with Christ with the help of God, my friends, family, and other Christians.
Everywhere. Good evening. Our class will be reciting Romans 8, 28 through 39 for you tonight. We learn these verses in the beginning of the school year. They have come in handy throughout the year, as we are not a perfect class. We might have forgotten to study for a history quiz, or we might have moaned and groaned when we had to do more diagramming, or when Mrs. Heilberg wanted to sing George Washington's song one more time. However, we are blessed, we are forgiven, we are loved, and most importantly, we are His. I asked my students whose lives were impacted by these verses to share their hearts with you tonight. You will be hearing from Jared Jackson, Ellie Butenith, Maggie Lynch, and Sydney Anderson. Please listen to the words we recite and be blessed as we have been.
Okay. What Romans 8:28 means to me is that there is hope and love in the name of God and Jesus Christ. Nothing can separate us from His love.
These verses we will recite are very powerful to me because they tell me that God loves me no matter what. Sometimes I think God forsakes me and doesn't love me because someone died or even if I have a fight with one of my friends. All of us probably feel like that from time to time, but when I feel like that, I just remember these verses and I know God still loves me.
I can't have my salvation taken from me. I can't be separated from it, nor can I be condemned by Satan or by people. I need these verses when I'm scared and when my faith's being tested. I also like these verses because they imply that my faith won't be taken from me because I'm not good enough.
In Romans 8, 28 through 39, there were a few verses about God's love that really stood out to me. In the passage, it says that nothing can separate us from God's love. God loves us no matter what. Even hardships and death don't get in God's way. We need to always stay close to God because He loves us and wants what is best for us. Romans 8 also says we are more than conquerors through Him who loves us. We can overcome anything, but only through God. God should be the center of attention, not us. We can't do anything without God. He is what makes us strong enough to be more than conquerors.
Hello. The Lord has just really blessed us this year. This class has personality to the nth degree, or as we learn, exponentially. Okay. So what's fun about this class is one of the things we've learned about this year is that sometimes our greatest strength is also our greatest weakness. And this class, probably the greatest weakness is they talk a lot. Oh my gosh. But that the greatest strength is, I hope that they will evangelize the world for God. They don't know a stranger. So it's exciting. And the other thing that we're known for is we're just a little bit competitive, myself included. So we like to win. Okay. Several times a week, the CLS students recite the pledge to the Bible and pledge to hide God's word in their hearts. This year, our class sought to memorize as much of the Navigator topical memory system as we could. This format is a wonderful foundation of solid truth that each growing Christian really should have. Out of the 73 total verses in the format, we were able to memorize 67 of those. And no, we won't recite them all tonight, so it's okay. We'll get out of here sometime. But the verses were divided into five categories: proclaim Christ, live the new life, rely on God's resources, be Christ's disciple, and grow in Christ-likeness. The kids did a great job. In our class, we also did quite a bit of a reader's theater, which is where you perform literature almost in a play form, but with the literature right in front of you. So we decided tonight to combine our reader's theater format with just a sampling of the verses that we memorized. We know that God's word is active and alive and a light unto our path. And our prayer is for you to be as blessed by the power and the beauty of his word as we have been this year. So I've asked a couple kids to share what this whole scripture memory has been for them and meant to them. And first one is Kayla McElhaney and then Josiah Voigt.
I would like to share how this year's verse memorization has impacted my life. Coming from a public school, I was not growing closer to God at all, and his word was not part of the school day at all. But by coming to CLS, it has really helped me grow closer to God. Memorizing his word and learning about it every day has really changed my attitude towards my parents and teachers.
This year, the topical memory system that Mrs. Stewart uses for biblical memorization has been very meaningful to me. It has helped me to memorize scripture, to learn how to witness to others, to acknowledge his glory, and to realize how short we all fall from God's perfect glory. But I have also realized how much God loves us by sending his son, Jesus Christ, to demonstrate his perfect love for us. I've grown closer to God more than ever this year, and I'm so thankful that God brought me here.
Yourselves.
It is the gift of God,
not by works,
so that no
Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone. The new is here.
All scripture is.
God breathed and is useful for
teaching,
rebuking,
correcting,
and training in righteousness. Come, follow me,
Jesus said,
and I will send you out to fish for people.
So do not fear,
for I am with you.
Do not be dismayed,
for I am your God.
I'll strengthen you
and help you.
I will uphold you
with my righteous right hand.
He who did not spare his own son,
but gave him up for us all,
how will he not also along with him graciously give us all things?
Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice,
holy and pleasing to God.
This is your true and proper worship.
But seek first.
His
kingdom
and
his
righteousness.
And all these things.
Will be given to you as well.
Dear children,
let us not love with words or speech,
but with actions and in truth. A new command I give you. Love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. We can do all things through Christ who gives us strength.
What a powerful, powerful presentation. I'm so thankful that our students have hid God's words in their heart and has been able to share it with you this evening. Well, this is the time of the graduation where we're able to present some awards. We give out the Presidential Award, and in your program, you'll be able to see some of the criteria within that. But these are for students who have been able to achieve a 3.5 to 3.94 cumulative grade point average at the total end of the school year. And so what an honor that has been and hard work for our students. So we're going to call them forward. And again, if you'll just come up in line across here, and Mr. Kringle will help us pass those out. Aaron Anderson. Micah Anderson. Jenna Barrett. Hannah Bell. Isabella Braid. Micah Cosmos. Laura Kranz. Ethan Davis. Jordan Dominey. Austin Eifert. Adeline Frederick. Ellie Johnson. Vince LeBergen. Gary Lean. Brady Magnan. Abigail McWilliams. Rebecca Knocker. Jordan Pierre. Jimmy Santarelli. Jacob Schaefer. Kirsten Stewart. James Tubbs. And Josiah Voigt. A lot of hard work has paid off. Please give them one more round of applause as they are having this seat. You guys may be seated. In addition to our silver presidential awards, we also have a gold presidential award, and this is for a student who has had a 3.94 and higher grade level throughout the whole entire year, or as a cumulative at the end. So, would you help me honor Sydney Anderson? Andrew Edwards. Maggie Lynch. And Eden Myers. Give them one more round of applause. This is a time in our graduation when we get to honor, and I found it one of the greatest honors, the Christian character of a few of our students. And so each teacher will be able to present this award to one student that they thought had outstanding character throughout the school year.
Okay, so what does a Christian character award winner look like to me? Moral excellence, solid when nobody is watching, no wild emotions, balance. Meekness, power under control, which says a lot at this age. Loving, hardworking, pursues excellence in and out of the classroom. Mature and constantly looking to grow in their faith. That's what my Christian Character Award winner for 2014 looks like. I just want to call her up here real quickly and then just talk a little bit more about her. So my Christian Character Award winner for 2014, Miss Adeline Frederick. I always thought Adeline was so quiet and so shy, and then we went to the Promised Land on that very first field trip, and I got to see her in action around some of her friends. I was like, wow. So there must be a lot more to this girl, because it was just totally blown away by how much personality was buried within this girl. But she totally, totally just blew me away this year with who she really is and who she's striving to be. Hard, conscientious worker in the classroom, ferocious competitor in sports, tough girl coming from a wrestler family, two tough wrestler boys just to survive, but gentle in spirit and tender in her heart. Loves to worship God, works hard at home helping out, hear it from parents, respected by her friends and peers completely. And God just has put her on my heart just so heartily. And the scripture that I thought about as I was praying for her was Proverbs 31. And I know when you read that, you think, well, geez, that's a married woman. That's a married woman there. You're not married yet, right? But this is the direction this young lady is heading. And so I was just so proud to be her teacher this year. Just a little from Proverbs 31. Her worth is far above rubies. She girds herself with strength. Strength and honor are her clothing. She shall rejoice in time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and on her tongue is the law of kindness. She watches over the ways of her family and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children will call her blessed. So thanks again for an amazing year, Adeline, and for being such a perfect example in and out of the classroom that you could be. Thank you.
I've heard it said, the excellence of gold is purity. The excellence of art is its beauty. So the excellence of man is his or her character. A person's character is the sum of his or her disposition, thoughts, intentions, desires, actions. Christian character is the manifestation of Jesus in his or her life. We can develop character by controlling our thoughts, practicing Christian virtues, guarding our hearts, and keeping good company. The recipient of this award for our classroom has done just that. This student has always exhibited a positive attitude towards school, our classroom, and others. This student doesn't just have head knowledge about the Word of God, but lives it daily. I've watched as this student evaluated friendships and chose to pursue those that would align with their own godly values. Not always easy to do, especially at this age. Those with Christian character will set a good example for others to follow, and their godly reputation will be evident to all. In Titus 2, verses 7 and 8, we read, "In everything, set them an example by doing what is good. In your teaching, show integrity, seriousness, and soundness of speech that cannot be condemned, so that those who oppose you may be ashamed because they have nothing bad to say about us." I can confidently say that this student's classmates would have nothing negative to say about our Christian character recipient, Austin Eifert. Two of the words I would use to describe Austin are good and integrity. In fact, you were the recipient of the Integrity Hero of the Faith Award a few months ago. And when I came across these verses in Titus mentioning doing what is good and show integrity, it was as if God gave this decision his stamp of approval. Austin, you were always doing what was good from day one until now. Most times, I'm sure you didn't think anyone was noticing, but I did. For you, it wasn't about being noticed, just about being like Christ. You deserve this award, and I pray that God continues to bless your life as you move on to bigger and better things. Congratulations.
Christian character, wow. Parents, thank you for diligently seeking to raise kids with Christian character at their very core. I had an abundance of excellence in my room this year. I could have given out many of these awards, and I was very blessed by your child. As I prayed for my students all year, I realized that what I was praying for was truly this along the school's mission statement, that these students would grow and develop spiritually, socially, and academically to impact their world for God. And I thought about it, and as I was thinking about it, I thought, golly, would I be picked, you know, for Christian character and just the standard that we're calling our kids to? And I just was remembered by God's goodness and his grace to us that Christian character is not some arrival at a perfect or unattainable standard, but it's the pursuit, the progress of becoming one who loves our Lord God with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and seeks to love our neighbors as we'd like to be loved. The student I chose for this year's Christian Character Award grew in all the mission statement areas. Spiritually, the student hungered for more of God's word, asked insightful, sometimes challenging, and honest questions, grew to get a better grasp of this holy God who loves each of us sinners so much that he sacrificed his only son to be with us for eternity. The student grew socially. They were consistent daily with not only common courtesy, politeness, and respect for anyone and everyone, which the world seems to be lacking anymore. But this student was just plain fun and a joy to be around. And finally, this student grew academically this year. The student has not only has a love for learning and a curiosity that makes him research and find out more and more on almost any topic, but this student also had a work ethic that enabled them to not only get the work done, but to get it done well. The student that consistently grew in these areas, spiritually, socially, academically, and that wonderfully exemplified Christian character for my class is our own Justin Gonzalez. And you could hear by the classmates that he is very well liked. Justin came to us this year new, and one of the greatest things that he would talk about is, wow, we just didn't do this in our public school. And just the delight that he had whenever we learned something new. And he was also the only kid and his dad who were up in the middle of the night to watch the lunar eclipse, right? Okay, so he came in telling us all about it. So Justin has just been a great addition to our school. And his kindness and his respect, it just makes him really well-loved and liked. So congratulations, Justin. I'd like to welcome the class, graduating class of 2014. So congratulations, yes. Aaron Anderson. You did it. Ivy Brown. Micah Cosmos. Armando Davis. Brian Deischer. Good job, Brian. Good job. Janelle Gilmore. Good job. You did it. Justin Gonzalez. Logan Grant. Good job, Logan. Zach Holly. Jack Hiring. Well done. Gianna Jones. Christopher Lee. Janae Lee. Adam Masters. Caleb McElhaney. Daniel McMillan. Good job. Rodney McNair. Emily Meyer.
Well done, Emily.
Blake Rosenquist. Haven Slater. Elena Smith. Angelica Tenuta. Josiah Voigt. And Taylor Whitey.
As they're getting ready, I'd like to say congratulations to all my chickabitties. It's a book we read. Micah Anderson. Sydney Anderson. Jenna Barrett. Ellie Butenith. Ethan Davis. Austin Eifert. Elijah Fairbanks. Brianna Fisher. Isabel Graziano. Kate Habel. Jared Jackson. Josiah Johnson. Elijah Jones. Grace Kerr. Maggie Lynch. Brady Magnan. Rebecca Knocker. Julia Olson. Johnny Pickering. Jordan Peer. Preston Shane. Jacob Schaefer. Josh Stair. Kirsten Stewart. James Tubbs. And Ben Wigman. Huzzah, huzzah.
Samuel Abbott. Hannah Bell. Colton Braid. Isabella Braid. Michael Bryan. Laura Krantz. Jaden Delgado. Jordan Dominey. Andrew Edwards. Adeline Frederick. Abigail Giese. Evan Grubbs. Ellie Johnson. Vinny Liebergen. Gary Lean. Travis Lucas. Abigail McWilliams. Eden Myers. Colton Salmi. Declan Sanderson. James Paul Santorelli. Anthony Savaglio. Jared Scott. Jacob Sikora. And Ethan Walnick.
And this is our class of 2014. Congratulations. As we bring our evening to a close, we are going to sing our school song. I have some students who's going to be helping me out with that. So if you would please stand, and the words will either be up on the screen or on the back of the program. A fun evening, and as we draw to a close, I just want to invite you to the reception afterwards over in the commons area. But as we close, I'm going to have Mrs. Nelson, our CLS superintendent, close in a word of prayer.
Great job.
Let's pray. Lord, thank you so much for this group of students, and I pray, Lord, not only for them, but for their families over the summertime. And I pray, Lord, for protection upon them. And I pray for your hand to be upon them for the rest of their lives, that these students would grow up to be fine young men and women of godly character. They'd not only represent Christian Life School well, but, Lord, they'd represent you well. We love you, Lord, and what a privilege it is to be part of this school. In your name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.